Hello and welcome to another outdoor tutorial in monitoring of forest resources. My name is Lutz Fehrmann and we are here in a forest area close to our faculty campus. It's only a 20-minute walk until you are in the forest. In this short tutorial, I like to demonstrate some measurements with a relascope, a so-called mirror relascope. It is a little bit difficult to explain this device without looking through it, but let me try. The inventor of this device is a very famous person in forest mensuration and forest inventory, and his name is Walter Bitterlich, was Walter Bitterlich, because he died some years ago. And he is the inventor of a very interesting plot design that we can use to estimate the basal area of a forest stand. We will come back to this plot design in a later tutorial. Here I like to explain how we can use the mirror relascope to measure upper diameters. Well, how does a relascope work? If you look through a relascope, then your view is separated into two parts. In the upper part, you have a direct view to the trees. In the lower part of your view, you see a lot of black and white scales. On the figure you see here, I only highlight some of the scales. You see that on the left-hand side of the view, there is a white stripe with the number 1 on it. And right of it, there are very small, narrow bands called a relascope unit. The interesting thing about these units is that they give you a fixed relation between the width of these white and black stripes and the distance to your target. And this works independent of the inclination angle of the instrument. So even if we look on a higher position on a tree stem, the width of this scale is exactly the same relation as if we look horizontally. So the device compensates the increasing distance if we look upwards on the stem. That also means if we would aim on a perfect cylinder, it would always be as wide, independent of the inclination angle that we have with our instrument. We can use a relascope for different measurements. We can use it to measure tree heights. The main use is to establish relascope plots or Bitterlich plots, as a topic of another tutorial that we have later. And we can make use of the fixed relations in this instrument to measure upper diameters. Diameters that we cannot reach with a caliper or a diameter tape. In this case, I like to use it to estimate an upper diameter of an oak tree. In the background, you see that I have marked an oak tree and I'm interested in the volume of the lower stem section, which is starting at the ground and goes up to about 7 meters where there is a dead branch on the left-hand side of the stem. What I need to calculate the volume is a diameter on the upper end and the lower end of the stem section. In order to get this upper diameter, we first need to establish a relation between the relascope units in this instrument and the diameter of this tree. And therefore, I will go to the tree and measure the diameter with a caliper exactly from this side where I'm looking on the tree. It is not necessary in this case that we keep exactly a measurement height of 1.3 meters because we use this measurement only to establish a relation. The diameter of this tree in this height is 58 centimeters. In the second step, I will now use the scales in this instrument and I try to find a distance to the tree where this diameter is covered by all 8 relascope units. As you can see in the figure, all these 8 relascope units are exactly covering the diameter of the tree. In my case, I found this distance about here. So in this distance, the diameter is covered by all the 8 units, and that means we can calculate the width or the diameter that is represented by each single relascope unit. We just need to divide 58 centimeters, the dBH, by 8 relascope units, and the result is 7.25. That means each single relascope unit represents 7.25 centimeters in dBH or in diameter. I can now make use of this fixed relation by pointing to the upper end of this stem section and count how many relascope units are left up there. It is important that you press and hold this button here on the instrument in order to allow for slope correction. I'm now aiming at the upper end of this stem section and I'm counting exactly 7 relascope units. So on the upper end of this lock, 7 units remain. Since we know that each of these units is 7.25 centimeters in diameter, we can now calculate the diameter on the upper end, which is 50.75 centimeters. And now your task. I like you to calculate the volume of this lower stem section using the formula of Smalian, which is a quite old and simple formula. I give you the input variables. We have measured an upper diameter of 50.75 centimeters. I have measured for you a lower diameter at the felling height of 65 centimeters. And the length of this lock is 7 meters. What you would need to calculate now is the cross-sectional area at the upper side of this lock. At the lower side, you calculate an average and you multiply with the length. So I'm curious about your results. Even if the relascope looks like a quite old-school instrument, which it is actually because it is produced in the same way since the 1950s, it is still a very expensive and useful device. We can also find more modern alternatives, electronic devices that are doing exactly the same things, keeping fixed relations to allow us to measure something in the distance. Another option to measure diameters that we cannot reach is terrestrial laser scanning. However, this will be topic of another tutorial. Thank you for watching so far and see you back in one of our next tutorials.